So good morning to all. My name is Leo. I am working in St. Martin's Engineering College as assistant professor in the department of IT. So today I am going to discuss about operating system. So operating system means what? So an operating system is a software which is acts as an interface between the user and the computer. So first of all, let me know what is software. What is software? Software is nothing but set of programs is called as a software. What type of programs? Set of test programs with documentation is called as a software. So what is the meaning of documentation? Documentation is nothing but the user manual. So how to operate the software, how to use the software, how to update the software is nothing but the documentation. So what is software? Test programs plus documentation. This completely is called as a software, right? So how many types of the softwares? So we have a two different types of the softwares. One is the application software. Application software. Second one is system software. So first come to the application software. So what is the application software? Application software is designed for only specific task. Which is designed for only specific task. For example, MS Office. So MS Office is used for the only creating the documents. So spreadsheet, it is doing something, Excel sheets, entering the data, details, information, we can enter into the spreadsheets. So compilers, browsers, databases, these are all that comes under the application softwares. So coming to the system software, what do you mean by the system software? System software is used to manage the all computer hardware. It manages the all hardware components. So for example, if you want to purchase one computer, if you want to purchase one new computer, then what you have to do? First, you need to go to the market. So you need to purchase some hardware. They are giving only hardware components like CPU, hard disk, monitor, cabinet, mouse. So they are giving only raw materials. So but after purchasing that raw materials, you need to assemble the all hardware components, right? After assembling that hardware components, your system is ready. But how can you use that computer hardware? Can you interact directly to the computer system? So it is not even possible. So it may be possible, but it is very difficult to use that computer system. In that situation, we need to install one software, that is a system software, right? Understand it. So system software is nothing but it supervises the all computer hardware, right? So coming to the, for example, operating system. Example, operating system is the one of the system software. Loader is the one of the system software. Debugger, like example. Right. So this is the types of the software, so application software and system software. Next, coming to the what is operating system? So operating system, already I told you, operating system is a software, one of the system software. It acts as an interface between the user and the computer. So what is the major role of operating system? What is the major role of operating system? So operating system is supervising the all hardware, computer hardware components. So for example, is the user one? User one. User two.
user 3 up to user n. N number of users so these users are wants to communicate with the computer system. They want to do something work on computer system. So here system, computer system is having CPU. The computer system has having CPU, IO devices and RAM, storage devices. This is a hardware component. So if user 1 wants to interact with the computer system directly, is it possible? It is not possible. So it may be possible but a difficult process to communicate with the hardware components, right? So in between user wants to install one system software, that is an operating system. So install one software, that is an operating system. Operating system is the first in system installed software. Operating system. Now, how can communicate user? So he purchased a computer or computer system. So now he is installed the operating system in that system. So how can he use that system? So user at the time user need to use the applications. User need to use the application. What type of any type of applications? Any type of application user can interact with the computer system. So here compiler may be taken. Compiler, browser, spreadsheet, like. This is the overall abstract view of the operating system, user, between the user and the computer system, abstract view of the computer system. So here what happens here, this operating system mainly used to provide a platform to run the applications. It is providing a platform to run the applications. So user to compile, user wants to write one program. For example, if you take addition of two numbers, so he wants to write one program. So that is addition of two numbers. After completion of this program, he wants to compile that program. So first of all, he compiles. This compiler is installed in your operating system, in your computer. So compiler, what it will do? Compile the user program. So he is not directly interacting with the operating system. He is not directly interacting with the computer hardware. Just he is using the application programs. Compiler is one of the application. So he is using the application. By this application, he is doing the some tasks, right? User 3 is searching something. He wants to find something into the browser. So he is not interacting with the computer hardware. Just he is accessing the browser and he is searching something, right? In such a way that this is the actual process to abstract of the operating system, right? Understanding, is it clear? So n number of users can use the computer hardware with the help of operating system, right? So next one, how many types of the operating systems here? So what are the different types of the operating system? We have so many types of the operating system, like batch file operating system, time sharing operating system, network operating system, distributed operating system, embedded operating system. So many operating systems are there. So mainly we are going to discuss only 5 operating systems in this subject. So what are the? So batch operating system, batch operating system. Second one is
time sharing operating system. Third one is distributed operating system. Fourth one is embedded operating system. Fifth one is real time operating system. So these are the main five operating systems we are discussing in this subject, right? First, batch file operating system. So what is meant by the batch? Batch is nothing but jobs. So job means set of programs plus IO instructions plus job means here one job. Batch operating system. This like for example batch one. So in that batch one, job one, job two, job three, job four. Right? Here job means what? Programs plus IO instructions plus control instructions. So job one is performing programs, job IO instructions, control instructions. So batch operating system is used to perform the task in batch wise. By using the batch operating system, users not able to interact with the computer system directly. In between, one operator is needed. If you want to communicate with the computer system by using the batch operating system, so we need to first complete our job. So for example, user 1, user 2, n number of users is there. So in that n number of users is in that, we need to segregate the batch wise. For example, I am taking job 1, job 2, job 3, job 4 is the batch 1. First, this batch 1 is done. Job 1 is done. He has written the programs and is complete the all IO instructions. Right? Job 1, job 2, job 4 is complete after completion of all the tasks. So batch 1 is interacting with the system. First of all, batch 1 is sent to the all instructions to the operator. Operator will interact with the computer system. That is batch operating system. The major disadvantage is that by using the batch operating system, user not able to interact with the computer system directly. In between, operator is there. If you complete your task, after completion of your task, you need to submit the operator. Operator will give the instructions into the computer system. Computer will produce the output. Right? This is the major disadvantage of using the batch operating system. Right? Okay. So in this session, we are discussing what is the software, what is the operating system. So how many types of the softwares, so how many types of the operating system, and just small introduction about the operating system. We will discuss briefly these five operating systems in the next session. Thank you.